今天跟大家一起分享的题目是要回来大声的归荣耀与神。
The topic I'd like to share with everybody today is return and glorify God with a loud voice.
这个意思就是说，我们蒙到神的恩典啊，我们要有这个回到主耶稣的面前，大声的荣耀天上的真神。
What this means is that when we receive grace from God, we need to return and glorify the Heavenly God, with a loud voice.
这个是记载在路加福音十七章。
And this is recorded in Book of Luke, chapter 17.
如果我们从十七章的十一节到十九节，我们就看到这里的教训。
And from verse 11 to 19, we can see the teaching here.
我们重点不是摆在主耶稣医病。
The emphasis of this passage is not the fact that Lord Jesus healed the sickness.
主耶稣要叫我们学习的是，当我们得到主耶稣的恩典好像医病之后，我们应当有怎么样的表现。
And what Lord Jesus wants to show us is, what kind of reaction or action we need to take after we receive the grace from God.
就这里的记载，就是要回去感谢他。
And the recording here is demonstrating that we need to give thanks to him.
我们可以看到第十一节告诉我们，主耶稣在传福音，经过一个村庄第十二节。
In verse 11 tells us that Lord Jesus, while preaching the gospel, went through a village.
还有十个长大麻风的看到主耶稣来了，远远的站着。
And the 10 lepers who saw that Jesus was coming, so they stood afar off.
十三节告诉我们他们就大声的跟主耶稣讲，耶稣啊，老师啊，可怜我们吧。
Verse 13, they lifted their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us.
因为他们长大毛风。
Because they were covered in lepers.
那大毛风是没有药治的。
So at the time, leprosy could not be cured with medications.
而且是极度的、高度的传染，很容易传染给别人。
And leprosy is highly contagious.
所以他们不能够住在家里，要住在野外。
So these people could not live at home, they have to live in a deserted area.
换句话说，他们没有办法过着正常的家庭生活。
In other words, these people cannot live a normal family life.
所以他们就是慢慢的这样子被这个毛风病最后越来越严重，最后就死掉了。
And so the leprosy will gradually get worse, at the end they would die.
这四个麻风病的人开始的时候看到耶稣来很高兴求主耶稣医治他们。
These 10 lepers in the beginning when they saw Jesus approaching, they were very happy, asking Lord Jesus to have mercy on them.
我们看到十四节主耶稣看见他们就跟他们讲说十四节说你们去把身体给祭司查看
In verse 14, Lord Jesus saw them and said to them, Go, show yourself to the priests.
因为主耶稣要医治他们。
Because Lord Jesus wanted to heal them.
按照摩西的律法，如果医治好了，麻风病好了，要给祭司来检查。
According to the Mosaic law, once their leprosy was cleansed, they need to be examined by the priests.
那祭司检查通过之后，他们就可以回家过正常的生活。
Once they are, they pass the exam by the priest, then they're allowed to go back home and live a normal life.
很感谢神他们就按照主耶稣的话，就去给祭司看。
Thank God they followed the word of Jesus, they shown themselves to the priest.
这里说他们去给祭司看的时候，这个麻风病已经被医治了。
And verse 14 described that, so it was that as they went, they were cleansed.
所以我们看得出来，这是个麻风病的人，很顺从主耶稣给他们的吩咐。
From here, we can see that these 10 lepers they follow the instruction of Jesus.
所以他们的麻风病都被医治了。
And that's why their leprosy was cured.
但是这件事情的 要给我们的教训并不是在这里。
But the teaching point of the story is not in this.
我们请看第十五节。
Let's read verse 15.
这个就是在讲说他们被肉体上的麻风病被医治之后他们这十个人、啊、的反应对主耶稣的反应。
And verse 15 describes the reaction of these 10 people after their leprosy was healed.
十个人里面当中有一个见自己已经好了就回来大声归荣耀与神。
And one of them saw that he was healed, returned, and with a loud voice glorified God.
然后我们继续看十六节，就能够知道他怎么样荣耀神呢
？Verse 16, we can see how he glorified God.
这里说他匍匐在耶稣的脚前，感谢主耶稣，那而且又说明说这个人是撒玛利亚的。
Verse 16, he fell down at Lord Jesus.Feet giving him thanks, and he was a Samaritan.
所以回来荣耀神，这意思就是来敬拜他，匍匐在主耶稣的脚前。另外，怎么敬拜呢？感谢主耶稣医治他的麻风病。
So he gave glory to God. He came back and worshiped God and give thanks to Jesus for healing his leprosy.
在这里特别、做一个解释说这个人、是撒玛利亚人撒玛利亚人不是真正的、犹太人
And here、especially mentioned that he was a Samaritan so Samaritan is not a true、Jew、
他们是混血的但是住在以色列国里面、
they were mixed、with other tribes and they live among the nation of Israel.
重点这一段的重点就是说这十个人看到主耶稣医治他们的麻风回来只有一个回来感谢荣耀天上的神。
And the focus of the story is the fact that after the 10 lepers were healed, only one of them came back to give thanks and to glorify God.
这个是一个很重要的属灵的教训。
And this is a very important spiritual teaching.
我们接着来看17到19这三节圣经。
Let's read verse 17 to 19.
我们刚刚看好好的来仔细来读主耶稣所讲的三句话。
And let's carefully read the three sentences spoken by Lord Jesus.
对这一个人回来感谢主耶稣，主耶稣要教我们三个教训。
To this person that came back and gave thanks to Lord Jesus, here Lord Jesus is giving us three teaching points.
第一个教训就是十七节。
The first teaching point is in verse 17.
十七节，路加福音十七章十七节说，耶稣说，洁净的不是十个人呢？那九个人在哪里呢
？Verse 17. So Jesus answered and said, "Were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9?"
那个十个麻风病全部都被医治了。
All the 10 lepers were healed.
只有一个回来。
But yet only one returned.
所以那九个人没有回来荣耀神。
These other 9 did not come back and give glory to God.
没有回来感谢耶稣。
They did not come back and give thanks to Jesus.
他们回家了。
They went back home.
他们很高兴能够跟家人在一起。
They were very happy to be with their families.
他可以过着正常的生活。
They were happy to be able to lead a normal life.
因为他的麻风病已经被医治了。
Because the leprosies, were cured.
他们忘记了回来感谢主耶稣。
They forgot that they need to come back and give thanks to Lord Jesus.
他们急着要过着他们正常的生活。
They were in a hurry to lead their normal life.
十个人，九个不回来。
And 9 out of 10 people did not return.
所以大部分的人得到神的恩典，但是啊，大部分的得到神的恩典的人啊。不会来回来感谢耶稣了。
The majority of people who are received from the grace of God does not return to give thanks to Jesus.
神带领我们走这条天国的路。
God has led us into this heavenly journey.
为了带领我们，我们就好像走在旧约的以色列人在走旷野一样。
And we can compare to the Israelites who was wandering in the wilderness.
旷野里面没有东西吃，没有水喝，又很热，又很冷。
In the wilderness, there was no food, there's no water, it was cold at night, and they get thirsty.
而且他们在旷野走了四十年。
And they wander in the wilderness for 40 years.
但是主神啊，就保守他们，给他们吃，给他们喝，给他们云柱火柱，给他们很好的住的环境。
But God watched over them, God gave them food to eat, water to drink, God gave them pillars of fire and cloud and guided them.
让他们都没有衣食住行，都没有什么缺陷。
So that they are lacking in nothing.
但是他们要进入迦南地之前，神的应许地之前，神借着摩西就警告他们。
But before they enter into the promised land, God through Moses warned them.
他们最后真正得到神的恩典了。
And at the end, they truly received the blessings of God.
但是进入这个应许之地之后，会发生什么事呢？
But what happened to them after they entered into this promised land?
这个十个麻风病得到医治之后，他们对主耶稣的反应是什么？
After these 10 lepers were healed, what was their reaction towards Jesus?
就好像旧约的以色列人进入迦南地之后，得到占领的迦南地之后，那么他们对神的表现是什么？
Just like the Israelites, after they entered into the land of Canaan, what was their reaction towards God?
在生命记第八章，神借着摩西啊，就事先就告诉他们。
In Deuteronomy chapter 8, God through Moses already forewarned them.
我们来看生命记第八章第十一节。
Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 11.
生命记第十八章的第十一节。
Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 11.
对不起，对，第八章十一节。
Excuse me, Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 11.
神说你要谨慎啊，免得忘记神啊，主你的神啊，不守他的诫命律例典章律例，就是我今日所吩咐你的。
Verse 11, beware that you do not forget the Lord your God by not keeping his commandments, his judgments, his statutes, which I command you today.
为什么神要事先警告他们呢？
Why is it that God needed to warn them ahead of time?
我们看十二节。
Verse 12.
十二节他这里讲，恐怕你吃得饱足，建这美好的房屋居住。十三节。
13.
你的牛羊加多了，你的金银增添了，并你所有的都全部增加了。十四节。
Verse 14.
你就心高气傲，忘记主你的神，就是将你从埃及地为奴之家领出来的。第十五节。
15.
引你经过那大而可怕的旷野。那里有火蛇、疖子、干旱、无水之地，他曾为你使水从坚硬的磐石中流出来。好，我们看到神在这里特别的警告他们。
Here, God especially warned them.
当你进入迦南地之后
，When you enter into the land of Canaan，
那个地方就比住在旷野好太多了。
And Canaan is much better than wilderness.
你的生活就越来越好了。
Then your life will gradually improve.
你的财产越来越多了。
And you will start building your assets.
那你第十四节你就骄傲起来了。
Verse 15, then your heart will be lifted up.
骄傲的一个表现就是忘恩啊，忘记了神曾经把你们把以色列人从埃及你们做奴隶 这个身份把你们救出来。
And while your heart is lifted, you forget about God, who brought you out of land of Egypt where you were slaves.
而且也忘记了神在旷野怎么样给他们衣食住群都没有缺。
And that they have forgotten how God guided them through the wilderness, while they were lacking nothing.
哎，这就是在历史里面啊，旧约的犹太人，神的选民，每一次啊，重复的患的问的属灵里面的忘记神的恩典的这个问题。
And this is a repeated mistake that the Israelites in the Old Testament continue to make. Is that they continue to forget about the grace of God.
他们忘记了神的恩典。
And they have forgotten about the grace of God.
在什么时候忘记神的恩典呢？
When did they forget about the grace of God?
就是在被神祝福平安发达的时候，富足的时候。
They forget about the grace of God when they are blessed by God, when they are prosperous.
所以我们在我们的困难得到神的解决帮助之后的反应很重要。
And so our response to God's grace after God has solved our problem, that response is very important.
到了新约圣经也是一样的，对新约的信徒啊，也是同样会犯这个问题。
And the believers in the New Testament continue to make the same mistake.
在启示录那里告诉我们，当时的这个教会啊，忘记了神对他们的爱。
In Book of Revelation describes how the church at the time had forgotten God's love towards them.
他们教会都建立得非常好了。
And while their church are built up very nicely.
而且所有的圣工都发展得很好。
And all the holy work is continuing to carry out well.
但是神责备他们。
But at the same time, God rebuked them.
我们参考启示录第二章第四节。
Let's read Revelation chapter 2, verse 4.
启示录的第二章第四节。
Revelation chapter 2, verse 4.
他说，然而有一件事啊，我要责备你啊，神要责备这间叫以弗所教会啊。
And here, God wants to rebuke this church of Ephesus.
责备他们什么呢？把起初的爱心离去了。
God rebukes them because they have left their first love.
这个起初的爱心就是从头我们相信神，从神得到了爱，这个问题啊，离弃了，不再重视了。
And which means that they have forsaken this initial first love they received from God.
我们很清楚的知道，这个起初的爱心就是主耶稣为我们钉十字架。
And we all know that this first love is referring to the fact that Lord Jesus was crucified on the cross for us.
就是十字架上的救恩啊。
And that is the salvation on the cross.
我们不再去重视了。
Which means that they no longer emphasize that love.
我们这个以弗所教会啊，在各方面的事工上面都很健全。
And this Church of Ephesus was very complete and excels in all different kind of works.
在第二节说他们能够很努力的工作忍耐，而且能够不容许恶人。
In verse 2 describe how they work, their labor, and they have patience, they cannot tolerate or bear those who are evil.
而且他们有属灵的辨别能力，知道什么是假使徒。
And they have tested those who say they are apostles or not, and they have found them liars.
他们啊，很努力啊，很努力的做工。
And they have labored diligently.
但是神责备他们说，把起初的爱心离弃了。
But God rebukes them and said that they have left their first love.
旧约圣经。以色列人进入迦南地，神的应许之地以后，他们就骄傲起来了。
And in the Old Testament, after the Israelites have entered into the land of Canaan, their heart was lifted up.
因为他们忘记了 神曾经拯救拯救他们出埃及经过旷野的恩典。
Because they had forgotten about God's grace and how he had led them through the wilderness to save them.
新约圣经以弗所教会努力地做教会的事工，但是呢，他忘不再重视了主耶稣的十字架救恩。
In the New Testament, the church of Ephesus, while they labored diligently to work for God, but they had forgotten and neglected the salvation of Christ.
同样的，犯了同样一个旧约以色列人的毛病，就是忘记了第一主耶稣在十字架上的救恩。
And they've forgotten the salvation, the grace of Lord Jesus' crucifixion on the cross, which is the same mistake that the Israelites made in the Old Testament.
这个问题会变成很重要。
And this is a very important problem.
主耶稣啊，在马太福音十八章那里给我们另外一个教训来解释这个问题。
In Matthew chapter 18, Lord Jesus gave us another teaching to further explain this concept.
这个是路加福音十八，马太福音十八章二十一节以下。
In Matthew chapter 18, verse 21 on.
是彼得在问啊，那个这个要饶恕弟兄啊几次啊？
Here Peter is asking, how many times does he need to forgive a brother?
主耶稣就告诉他，你要饶恕七十个七次。
And Lord Jesus told him to forgive up to 70 times, after 70 times 7.
那是70个7次是怎么解释呢？
How do you explain the 70 times 7?
所以主耶稣就用一个比喻。
So here Lord Jesus used a parable.
这个比喻就从23节开始，一直到到34节。
And this parable starts from verse 23 to verse 34.
他就说有一个王啊，要跟一个仆人算账。
And verse 23, there's a king that wanted to settle accounts with his servants.
我简单来讲，简单讲一下啊，因为这个仆人啊，在这个比喻当中啊，这个仆人没有办法，因为欠他的主人太多了，1000万，他没有办法还呐，不可能还。
And in this account, the servant owed the master too much money, 1,000 talents, more than what he can afford.
所以主人本来的意思啊，要把他所有的财产，包括他家里的所有妻子子女啊，全部都要把他卖掉。
And the master commanded for him to sell his wife, his children, all that he had.
26节啊，这个仆人啊，就急了哦，赶快来。求这个主人啊，跪着说，宽容我啦，我将来会还你。
And the servant therefore fell before him, saying, Master, have patience with me, and I will pay you all.
他觉得他根本没有办法求，所以啊，他求他的主人的怜悯，赦免他。
He knew he could not pay back, so he begged for his master's mercy to forgive him.
27节就这个比喻里面的主人啊，就看到他就动了慈心啊，就怜悯他了，把他释放，而且不但释放了，而且免了他所有的欠的钱。
In verse 27, the master of the servant was moved with compassion, released him, and forgave him the debt.
他欠了主人有1000万。
And he owed the master 1,000 talents, 10,000 talents.
他很高兴地走出来。
So he was happy to leave.
1,000万都不必还了。
Because he did not have to pay back 10,000 talents.
但这个比喻里面，主耶稣在28节说，他一出来，看见有一个同伴欠他10两银子。
And after he left, he came out, he saw his fellow servant who owed him 100 denarii.
然后就抓着这个同伴啦，你把我的钱全部要还给我。
So he was holding on to his fellow servant, and asking him to pay back.
他的同伴也是就很紧张啊，就求他，哎呀，这给我一点期限啊，请你赦免我啦。
Then his fellow servant fell down on his feet and begged him, saying, have patience with me, and I will pay you all.
哎，但是这个人呢，刚刚主人把他一千万都赦免了，人家欠他十两啊，啊，他竟然把他下到监牢里面去了。
And this servant who was forgiven 10,000 talents earlier now is putting his fellow servant in the jail for 10 denarii.
哎，那么最后啊，主耶稣就告诉我们，这个比喻的教训是什么意思。
And at the end, Lord Jesus taught us what is the point of this teaching.
哎，我们看三十二节。
Let's read verse 32.
马太福音18:32。
Matthew chapter 18, verse 32.
哎。主人听到了这个人呢、啊、这样子做、啊、就把他叫过来。
And then his master who had called him and said to him,
对他说你是个恶奴才啊。
And he said, you wicked servant.
嗯，为什么他是一个会这个邪恶的人呢？
Why is he wicked?
嗯，这个主人就解释给他听。
So master explained this.
哎，你这个不久啊，你在那边求我，我都把你的一千万都赦免掉了。
Because I forgave you all that debt, 10,000 talents, because you begged me.
但是你被赦免之后，马上在三十三节啊，就把你的同欠你十两的这个同伴下到监牢。
After you are forgiven of your debt, you put your fellow servant who owe you 100 denarii into prison.
哎，你这里主耶稣说，你不当怜悯你的同伴，像我怜悯你一样吗？
Do you not also have compassion on your fellow servant, just as I had compassion on you?
哎，所以这个主人呢，就把他下到监牢去。
And so this master put him in the jail.
哎，那么这个教训在告诉我们什么？
So what is this teaching telling us?
哎，这个仆人啊，欠主人一千万的时候，他很紧张，哇，大声的求主人原谅他。
When this servant was owing 10,000 talents to his master, he was very nervous. He was begging for the master to forgive him.
哎，但是他出来以后，看见他的另外一个同伴只欠他十两银子，他却不怜悯他。
But yet, when he came out, he saw his fellow servant who owed him 100 denarii, yet he did not have pity on him.
哎，所以这个主人就告诉他，哎，要告诉他，你错在哪里呢？你错在说你忘记了我赦免你一千万了。
And what the master is reminding him that his mistake was that he forgot that he owed the master 10,000 talents.
所以主耶稣说，这种的信徒啊，要把他丢到地狱去了。
And so, Lord, just tell us that this kind of believer needs to be thrown in Hades.
哎，回到路加福音十七章。
So let's return back to Luke chapter 17.
哎，这十个麻风病的人医都医好了，嗯，就回家了，忘记主耶稣给他们的恩典。
The 10 lepers, they went home after they were healed, completely forgot about the grace of Jesus.
我们被得到神的恩典，把神的主耶稣的恩典忘记了，这种忘恩的人啊，主耶稣说啊，你是邪恶的，你要被关起来啊，到地狱去了。
If we have forgotten the grace that we received from Lord Jesus will call us wicked, and that we would be put in the Hades.
哎，所以这个在路加福音十七章。第十七节。
In Luke chapter 17, verse 17.
哎，耶稣说，洁净的不是十个人吗？那九个在哪里呢？怎么都不回来了呢？
Jesus said, were there not 10 cleansed, but where are the 9?
哎，这个教训是什么呢？
What is his teaching here?
这九个人不回来，就是忘记了主耶稣给他们的恩典。
These 9 lepers did not return because they forgot about the grace of Jesus.
忘恩的人啊，主耶稣要处罚他们。
And these people that are ungracious will be punished by Lord Jesus.
好，我们看在第二个教训，这是十八节。
And the second teaching is in verse 18.
哎，十七章的十八节，路加福音说：“啊，这个除了这个外族人，再没有别人回来归荣耀与神吗
？”Luke chapter 17, verse 18, were Were there not any found who returned to give glory to God except this foreigner?
哎，所以那十个人里面有一个是撒玛利亚人，就是犹太人认为的，外邦人啊，哦。
And among the 10 lepers, one of these was a foreigner, and it was a Samaritan.
所以是一个，对我们今天来讲，就是还没有信的人啊，外邦人啊。
And today, and this foreigner is an unbeliever, somebody who has not believed yet.
啊，另外九个主耶稣的暗示就是说，都是犹太人，都是神的选民。
And Lord Jesus is inferring that the other nine were Jews.
嗯，就是今天来讲，就是信主的信徒啦。
In today's term, they are believers who believe in Jesus.
哎，这个给我们很大的启示啊。
And this is a great revelation to us.
哎，我们信主的人蒙神了很大蒙了主耶稣很大的恩典。
Those of us who believe, we have received tremendous amount of grace from God.
哎，主耶稣为我们的罪钉死在十字架。
Lord Jesus has crucified on the cross because of our sins.
他为我们做赎罪祭。
And he was a propitiation for us.
哎，我们因为回认罪悔改信耶稣受洗。
Because we admit to our sin, we repent, we believe in Jesus and receive the baptism.
哎，所以我们受洗之前的罪啊，主耶稣都用宝血把你赦免掉了。
And because of that, all the sins that we have committed prior to baptism, Lord Jesus already washed them all away with his blood.
因为如果我们没有得到主耶稣的赦免，那我们将来审判的时候就要下地狱的。
Because if we don't have the forgiveness of Lord Jesus, then we will go to Hades on the day of judgment.
但是我们如果没有回来感谢耶稣的话，
But if we do not return and give thanks to Jesus,
而 还没有信主的人却会感谢耶稣的话，
But yet, those who have yet to believe knows how to give thanks to Jesus.
如果我们是主耶稣的话，我们心里会怎么想啊？
If we were Lord Jesus, how does that make us feel?
主耶稣一定很伤心的。
Lord Jesus must feel very sad.
一个信徒，一个神的选民，应该知道神的恩典，要回来谢恩的，感谢神的。
A believer, a follower of Christ should know to return back to him to give thanks to him.
在我们需要神，主耶稣来帮助的时候，那样子的祷告，但是主耶稣给我们解决困难了，我们就忘光了。
We pray fervently when we need help from God, but yet after he solved our problem, we have forgotten about his grace.
就完全把主耶稣忘记了。
And we have completely forgotten about Jesus.
还不如一个没有信的人，外邦人还会回来感谢呢。
Then we are worse than a foreigner who even a foreigner knew to return to give thanks to Jesus.
我觉得这个是值得我们好好的常常放在心里面的一个很重要的警告。
I believe that this is a very important warning that we need to put in our hearts and think about it constantly.
因为这个结果是天国跟地狱之差。
Because the result is the difference between heaven and hell.
我们来看第三个教训，第十九节。
Let's look at the third teaching, which is verse 19.
第三个教训，主耶稣就对那个回来的人，感谢的人说，起来走吧，你的信救了你。
Verse 19, and he said to him, Arise, go your way, your faith has made you well.
你得救了，是吧？
And that you're saved.
你真正十个里面只有这个人真正蒙主的拯救。
And among the ten, this is the only person that has been saved.
得到恩典的人里面只有十分之一的人，百分之十的人会回来感谢神。
Among those who have received grace from God, only one out of ten, which is 10% of people that will come back and give thanks to God.
我们信耶稣，对。的最后的目的，就是 我们的灵魂将来能够进天国得救。
When we follow Jesus and believe in Jesus, the ultimate goal is that our soul will be saved one day and we will have salvation.
但是很多的人他只要主耶稣给他地面上的福气。
But for many people, all they're asking for is the earthly blessings from Lord Jesus.
他们只要在求求耶稣在他们活着的时候有什么困难来解决他们的困难。
And they only pray that the Lord Jesus will help them while they're alive.
就好像这十个麻风病的人求主耶稣解决他们的麻风病。
Just like the 10 lepers, they asked Lord Jesus to heal their leprosy.
没有错，他们的麻风病得到了医治。
And indeed, their leprosy was healed.
就好像我们今天我们的困难得到主耶稣的解决。
Just like today, our problems may be solved by Lord Jesus.
但是主耶稣没有对这种人说你的信救了你啊，没有说你得救了。
But Lord Jesus did not say to these kind of people that your faith has made you well.
主耶稣只有对回来感谢他的人说你的信救了你。
Lord Jesus only said to the person that came back to give thanks to him that his faith has made him well.
弟兄姊妹啊，我们要把这个事情啊牢牢地记在我们的心中。
So brothers and sisters, we need to remember this in our hearts.
我们信耶稣最终的目的是要进天国得救的。
Our ultimate goal for believing Jesus is to be able to go into a heavenly kingdom and to be saved.
因为在地上的是暂时的，都会过去的，都会没有的。
Because what is on this earth is temporary, is transient, it will pass.
如果我们没有得到 最终的将来的天国，那我们信的不是没有什么益处吗？跟其他的人不没有什么两样吗？
If we don't reach their heavenly kingdom, our ultimate goal, then our life will be no different than others.
所以我们要很注意，要注意这个教训。
So we must be careful and learn from this teaching.
或许啊，我们可以在教会里面做很多的事工。
And it's possible that we can do a lot of holy work at church.
但是呢，把主耶稣的救恩忘记了。
But we can forget about the salvation of God.
如果我们这样子到最后还是不能得救啊。
If we are like this, then at the end, we will not be saved.
主耶稣在这里说，你的信救了你。
Lord Jesus here says that your faith has made you well.
这什么意思呢？
What does this mean?
在这里怎么表现出来这个人对主耶稣的信心呢？
And how does it show that this person has faith towards Jesus?
从这里我们是看见这个人得到恩得到医治之后会回来感谢荣耀神，这叫做他的信心。
This person after being healed return and give praise to God. This is his faith.
这个叫做真正的信心。
And this is called true faith.
那么他在之前呢、这十个麻风病大声的在求说，耶稣夫子啊，可怜我们嘛，把我们医治我们。
In the beginning, all 10 lepers were crying out to Jesus, Teacher, Master, heal us.
他们有一点有些信心。
While they have some faith,
那个信心只是来拯救他们肉体上的麻风病。
And that faith was limited to healing of their physical leprosy.
但是这个回来感谢的这个撒玛利亚人，他的信心可以拯救他到天国去。
But the faith of the Samaritan man, his faith is able to save him, save his soul.
所以我们看见，在这里更重要的教训，就是主耶稣在这里所讲的最后三句话。
And the important teaching here is on the three verses spoken by Lord Jesus.
我们不要学大部分的人，很容易忘记主耶稣的救恩。
Let us not learn from the majority of people who easily forget about the grace of Jesus.
我们一定要学习这个外邦人这个外族的人能够 回来感谢荣耀主耶稣。
We need to learn from this foreigner, this Gentile, who returned and praised Jesus.
那第三个教训，如果我们这样子做，我们就能够有信心的表现，而且能够得救。
And thirdly, if we do so, then it will show our faith, and our faith will make us well.
首先啊，我们不要忘记主耶稣的恩典。
So first of all, let us not forget about the grace of Jesus.
我们要学习保罗。
We have to learn from Paul.
保罗一生当中绝对不会忘记主耶稣怎么拯救他。
And Paul never forgot in his entire lifetime how Jesus saved him.
在使徒行传记载着有三次保罗在讲说主耶稣第一次拯救他的见证。
There are three times in the book of Acts how Paul recalls how Lord Jesus saved him.
然后到了提摩太前书，他在年老的时候，他又重新的更强调的主耶稣救他。
And in 1 Timothy, when he was more advanced in age, he again mentions how Jesus saved him.
那个时候他已经服侍主耶稣三十年了，差不多三十年了。
At that time, he already served Lord Jesus more than 30 years.
他建立了很多的教会，行了很多的神迹奇事。
He performed many miracles, and he established many churches.
他告诉这个年轻的传道人提摩太。
And he is teaching the young preacher, Timothy.
他说基督降世就是为了拯救罪人。
He said that Lord Jesus came to this world so that he can save sinners.
那个是记载在提摩太前书第一章十五节。
And this is recorded in 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 15.
然后他说主耶稣拯救他。
And he further mentioned Lord Jesus saved him.
然后他说我是一个罪人中的罪魁。
And he says that he was the chief of all sinners.
他为什么说年老的时候他就已经做了很多的工神的工作，他说我是一个罪人中的最最犯罪最大的一个头目。
Why would he say that he is the chief of all sinners after that he has performed many holy work?
因为他年老的时候还记得，而不但还记得，还跟提摩太讲，我在三十年前第一次主耶稣怎么样呼召我的，那个时候，因为他那个时候带兵啊去抓基督徒了。
And even when he's advanced in age, he's telling the young Timothy how Lord Jesus called upon him for the first time when he was persecuting the Christians.
他说我是一个大罪人啊。
So he said that he was a chief of sinners.
换句话说，他越服侍神，跟主耶稣认识越久，他越觉得他的罪越多，越来越多。
In other words, the longer he follows Jesus, the more he served Jesus, the more he realized that he was a sinner.
这个意思就是说，他觉得我当年去追杀基督徒啊，我实在是一个罪魁啊。
And so he realized that in the earlier years, when he was persecuting the Christian, he was a chief of all sinners.
蒙主耶稣的拯救啊。
And he was saved by Jesus.
然后主耶稣还用他去传福音。
Jesus used him to preach the gospel.
他不敢忘记主耶稣的救恩。
He dare not forget about the salvation of Jesus.
不但不敢忘记，而且大声的向世界上的人写在圣经里面说，我虽然做了那么多的做着那么多的工作，建那么多教会，行那么多神迹奇事，但是我越来越知道我是一个罪人，不敢忘记。
Then he further bravely proclaimed and even written in the Bible how he, even though performed many miracles, he did many holy work, then he never forgot that he was a sinner.
弟兄姊妹，我们应该回想一下，第一次我被主耶稣呼召拯救的时候，那个经验绝对不要忘记。
So, brothers and sisters, let us not forget how we were called, the experience we feel the first time we were called by Jesus.
我们要告诉我们的家人，主耶稣怎么样来拯救我。
We have to testify to our family how Jesus saved us.
要叫我们的家人，让我提醒我们自己，不要忘记主耶稣的恩典。
And that our family and ourselves never forget about this grace of God.
记得吗？这个人，这个罗马，这一个撒玛利亚的这个麻风病的人，是回来主耶稣的脚前跪在地上荣耀神。
And this Samaritan leper who was healed, he came back and knelt before Jesus' feet and praised him.
然后感谢主耶稣的救恩。
And he gave thanks to Jesus for his salvation.
我们年纪越大，服事的工作越多，越知道自己的罪很重，更重。
The older we get, the longer we serve God, the more we realize that our sin is so great.
我们也要每天要感谢神啊。
And so every day, we also need to give praise to God.
我们不要忘记主耶稣十字架上的救恩。
Let us not forget about the crucifixion on the cross.
但是我们每天能够活着也要感谢神。
So we need to give thanks to God for the fact that we're alive.
我们参考主耶稣所讲的主祷文。
And let us take a look at the Lord's Prayer.
那是记载在马太福音第六章。
And this is recorded in Matthew chapter 6.
记载在从第九节一直到十三节。
Verse
9 to 13. 前面的两三节圣经是讲到我们在祷告里面要以神的名，为神的名，神的国，神的旨意来祷告。
And the first 2 to 3 verses describing how in our prayer we need to pray for his name, for his kingdom, and his will.
但是从第十一节开始，就是我们这个祷告要从我们人的角度向神祷告。
Verse 11, then we start praying from a human's perspective.
比如说第十节，我们日用的饮食今日赐给我们。
Verse 11, give us this day our daily bread.
第十二节，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债。
Verse 12, forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors.
十三节，不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶。
Verse 13, do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
这些都是从人的角度来向神祷告。
This is praying to God from a human's angle.
但是在向从人的角度向神祷告的第一点记载在第十一节。
And the first part of praying to God from a human's perspective is recorded in verse 11.
我们日用的饮食今日赐给我们。
And give us this day our daily bread.
很多人觉得这个怎么会放在祷告文里面呢？
Many people wonder, why would you put this in the Lord's Prayer?
主耶稣 在接着下来的马太福音第六章有讲这些衣食住行主耶稣都会给你你不必祷告。
And because later on in chapter 6, the Lord Jesus said that you don't need to pray about your food because it'll be provided.
只要追求神的国、神的义就好了。
You only need to seek after the kingdom and righteousness of God.
而且不要忧虑明天只要今天，你只要注意今天就可以了。
And don't worry about tomorrow, only live for today.
但是这里就告诉我们我们要对我们今天神给我的这些衣食住行我要放在我的祷告里面。
But yet, in verse 11 is telling us, and we need to remember the food and the clothes that God gave us today.
这个就是进一步的感恩
And this teaches us that we need to be thankful.
为什么我们每天能够吃的东西衣食住行我们要感谢神呢？
Why do we need to give thanks to God for our daily bread?
而且是讲今天不是昨天，也不是明天。
And we give thanks for our daily bread today, not yesterday's and not tomorrow's.
这个就是表示我们知道我们的生命今天的生命是在神的手里了。
And this is because we know that our life today is in the hands of God.
今天我还活着，因为是神的恩典。
Today, the fact that I'm alive is because of grace of God.
等一下，我们要一起祷告。
So in a little bit, we'll pray together.
我们有可能会念主祷文。
We may read the Lord's Prayer together.
但是我们在祷告当中应该要感谢神。
But in our prayer, we also need to give thanks to God.
感谢什么呢？
What do we give thanks about?
因为今天我还活着了。
We should give thanks for the fact that I'm alive today.
为什么我可以活着呢？
Why is it that I'm able to be alive?
因为主耶稣使我活着。
Because Lord Jesus make me alive.
这个活的健康啊，这就是很大的恩典。
And to be alive and healthy is a great blessing.
不管你要做世界上的事情，也是要活着健康啊，你才有办法做。
Even if you want to accomplish things on earth, you have to be alive and you have to be healthy.
你要做神的工作，也是要有健康啊，你才有办法做，还要活着健康啊。
If you want to do the holy work of God, you also need to be alive and you need to be healthy.
今天能够做一点神的工作，这是神给我的机会啊，神给我的生命啊。
And today, if I'm able to do the holy work of God, it's because God has given me this opportunity to do so.
所以主耶稣把它放在主祷文，里
面。And that's why Lord Jesus put this in the Lord's Prayer.
而且把这个日用的饮食今日赐给我们放在从人的角度来看是第一条感谢的东西。
From man's perspective, to give this today our daily bread is the first thing that we need to be thankful for.
我们今天用这个来彼此的勉励。
So this is our mutual encouragement today.
让我们了解。
To help us understand.
我们要过着一个感恩的生活。
That we need to live a life of thanksgiving.
常常去想主耶稣给我的恩典。
We need to often think about the grace of Lord Jesus.
最重要就是主耶稣为我钉十字架。
And the most importantly, how Lord Jesus was crucified for me on the cross.
第二点，我今天还活着，还健康，这就是主耶稣给我的恩典。
The second point is the fact that I'm alive and I'm healthy today. This is also a grace of God.
进一步，我有这个健康，有生命，我应该献给神用。
And furthermore, since I am alive and I'm healthy, I need to give my life to God for Him to use.
保罗说啊，我不再为自己而活，而是为我死里复活的主耶稣而活。
Paul says that he no longer lives for himself, but he lives for Christ who has died and resurrected.
我们感谢神，我们今天的聚会就到这里。
And we give thanks to God, this will conclude our service tonight.
因为时间原因那我们就一起跪下祷告。
And let's now pray together.
我们在祷告当中先不要祈求，先感谢。
In our prayer, let us not start withasking for things, but start with thanksgiving prayer.
然后我们求主，除了要感谢主耶稣十字架救恩以外，而且也要求主耶稣给我们个人了解，主耶稣在我们身上的恩典。
And in our prayer, let us pray in addition to praying for his salvation on the cross, but also pray so that he understand our purpose in life.
然后让我们求神给我们机会能够报恩能够为他而活为他传福音。
Lord Jesus, to give us the opportunity to repay his blessing to preach gospel for him.
我们一起跪下祷告。
So let's kneel down and pray together.